The Chamber's Member Services Department is proud of a lot of accomplishments and a lot of our programs that we've had over the past 125 years.
One of the biggest accomplishments for Government Affairs this year was our ability to lobby at the state legislature on behalf of our members and businesses.
Part of our challenge is to continue to remain relevant for another 125 years, and so this is a critical part of us continuing to stay relevant.
And one of the things we're most proud of, I think, this year is just the record-breaking campaign that we had.
Well, this past year we had quite a bit to work on. We started the year with a Wake Tech school bond, successfully passing that.
The Regional Transportation Alliance has had a number of really terrific successes this year. One in particular that I would reference would be the opening of 540 all the way to Holly Springs.
One of the greatest accomplishments of the Membership Services Department this year is not only building on the programs that we've developed over the past 125 years, like the Young Professionals Network. We were very excited to see 25% growth over the past few years.
And maintaining economic development incentives is extremely important in our community. We want to continue to foster an environment for growth where we can bring good businesses and good jobs to our community and maintain many of the companies that are here.
Well, this year we had two assignments. The first assignment was to provide a lot of coverage support for the Marketing Partners campaign. So we raised over $500,000 to support what was going on with the marketing campaign, and we're really proud of that accomplishment. The second was our branding audit this year.
We certainly had a lot of volunteers involved, almost close to 200 volunteers this year. A lot of them new, and really leaned on the leadership committee that we had. It was 14 folks that were on that committee. Over 50 companies that we had represented, and we raised $1.722 million, which was a record for the chamber, and one that we got done on time and on budget. So really proud of that with the efforts of everyone on the team.
The $200 million bond for Wake Tech was important because that is a great educational resource for our community that had tremendous capital needs. Having a strong public school system is a great value for people that live in a community.
A huge benefit for commuters in the area, and we've also put in place the next piece of the puzzle in trying to get 540 all the way around to the 40-70 intersection in the south part of the region. So by extending 540 around the western and southern parts of the triangle, that not only helps people in automobiles move, but it also adds other options for public transportation in those areas.
This passing of the school bond on October 8 provides 16 new schools. It provides for 9 major renovations. Again, it will allow for the growth in our school system of about 20,000 seats, which is what we think will be basically the growth in the system over the course of the next 5 years.
Well, you get one shot at this generally, about every 4 years. And we have tried 3 times. So we were one of 53 finalists that got the second and third rounds at the PNC Arena for the NCAA Men's Final Four basketball tournament. Kind of cool when you think about our folks bringing lots and lots of people.
The Small Business Department at the Raleigh Chamber represents all chamber members who have under 50 employees. You may be interested to know that this represents over 85% of all chamber members. So the Small Business Department stays very busy. In fact, this department hosts over 150 events each year.
Well, the more we grow innovative companies in the Raleigh area, the more that we're going to keep pace with and stay ahead of the changes in the economy. And so as we're attracting businesses and growing businesses in the area, those are going to be the businesses of the future. You know, a lot of the jobs that our young folks are going to be working in the future don't even exist today, but they're in the minds of the entrepreneurs that are creating innovative companies today in the Raleigh area.
So we're pretty excited about being one of the finalists and then chosen for our area being second and third rounds for NCAA basketball. You do the numbers are pretty strong. Lots of people come visit, they spend nights in the hotels, and they buy things like food and beverage. So it is an economic driver. But more than that, it gets to showcase our area
The Business Expo this year was incredibly successful. The Chamber hosted over 200 companies that exhibited and participated in the Expo. We had increased attendance, and in fact, the Expo was sold out. This was a huge success for the Small Business Department, and certainly it's an indicator of the economy and that companies are doing business and they are doing business at the Chamber.
One of the ways that we've been working to do that is through something that's called Innovate Raleigh. And it really is a way for us to bring the entrepreneurial and technological innovation community together to share, you know, best practices, to, you know, form together and create kind of a center mass that both helps all of them to be successful within the community. You know, this year's been a great year for the Chamber and for economic development. You know, think about the numbers. You know, we've created over $250 million worth of additional investment in the community, 92 new announced and expanding businesses, and 5,000 jobs. That's big numbers for anybody, and clear signs of success for the year.